reichsten Leute. Das will ich alles gar nicht wissen. Mein kleiner grüner Kaktus steht draußen am Balkon. Holleri.
Ein Lied geht um die Welt, ein Lied, das euch gefällt.
I chose a particular song. This song goes around the world, which in German is called Ein Lied geht um die Welt. You can look up every single artist there is there. Some of them have been dead for 40, 50 years, and today I can sit here in London and listen to their music, and something about their story is still with us. And so A Song Goes Around the World is really the perfect title for a show that features songs from all around the world performed in London. The show features songs in German, Russian, Yiddish and French. It's really all going between 1910 and 1960. Our songs are all about really sharing real emotions. For instance, the French chansons are called chansons réalistes. They're about chansons about real life events. The Piaf song is also quite big boots to fill if you sing songs by such big legends. The show is going to be performed at the St. James Studio on the 16th of May at 8 p.m. It'll be wonderful. You can have some drinks in the bar, listen to some wonderful European music.
Sagt zu der Rufe. So, A Song Goes Round the World is going to Upstairs at the Gatehouse from the 25th to the 30th of April 2017. It features songs by Edith Piaf, the comedian harmonists, Alexander Vitinsky, Hildegard Knef. As you can hear, all these songs are originally from France, Germany. There's Yiddish songs and Russian songs, which all together is my cultural background. In times of recent political upheaval with Trump, Brexit, and in times where we all seem to drift apart culturally, I've really wanted to create something and make a musical response, which is A Song Goes Round the World. In German, Ein Lied geht um die Welt. And I think there is no better title for a show that features songs from all around the world performed in London. I'm going to be joined by my colleague Inga Davis Rutter on the piano and her wonderful trio. Join us for a wonderful evening of European chansons. You can book your tickets online, over the phone, or in person in the box office. We're there from the 25th to the 30th of April. I'm looking forward to seeing you there.
Als Feinde gegen den Kleinen nimmt das Heft nicht ein Gewalt. Heilig Melech ist geboren sehr fröhlich. Ist geboren sehr fröhlich. Heilig Melech hat er uns getäunt die Tfillen und hat angetäunt die Brillen und geschickt nach die Fiddlers die Zwei.
Daniel, first of all, why did you want to call it A Song Goes Round the World?
Brexit. Uh-huh. May 2016. Being European in London was quite a punch in the face. Even prior to the whole campaign was quite shocking for somebody who lived here for 6 years, who employs British citizens, who considers himself not particularly British, but European, never had any doubts that anything about this should change, will change, or ever will. In any form be weird. And then suddenly the campaign got really nasty, loads of racism, loads of anti-Semitism, Islamophobia, everything you want from a political campaign in 2016. And I was desperate to do something, but I'm not a political person. I'm not in politics. What I can do is arts. And my first job that I produced was called You Won't Succeed on Broadway If You Don't Have Any Jews, which was also a response to rise in anti-Semitism. So this really was a response to the rise of xenophobia. And just wanted to bring people together through music. And the stories of the people whose songs I'm singing, they all have really tragic lives. But something that really is common ground is that even in World War II, Germans would listen to French songs. For some reason they would, because music brings people together regardless of faith and regardless of heritage and regardless of anything. Music is something that always connected people throughout, ever.
Ich will dir sagen, dich gleich zu hören, oh, du sollst mir Liebe erklären. Wenn du willst mit den Augen, wollte ich mit dir gefragen, wo du willst, sag mich nicht an. Und wenn du hast, dann bist du nur sicher. Wenn du weißt,
and A Song Goes Round the World means exactly that. We'll sit here in London, and we'll all be in one room with people from loads of different places. Myself being European, the majority of audiences probably will be British. And all these songs from all around the world we performed in London. So I thought, and then I found a song by Josef Schmidt, Ein Lied geht die Welt, which in English means Song Goes Around the World. And I couldn't think of a better title, really.
Well, in Yiddish, it's Beshert, it was meant.
Beshert, exactly, exactly that.
Yeah, so you've actually got songs in Yiddish, in French, obviously in German, any other languages?
And Russian as well.
А вдали мелькали огоньки. Эх, когда бы мне теперь за вами душу бы разветь от тоски. Дорогой длинной, погодой лунной, ведь не той, что вдаль летит свинья, но со старинною и семиструнною.
So you've chosen today to do this wonderful preview here at Selig Court.
Selig Court, yes.
Which means blessed, actually, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah. So that's another lovely sort of coincidence, isn't it?
Yes, well, I received a lovely email from Sandra Alexander, who works for Jewish Care, asking if I would possibly consider performing the show for a group of Holocaust survivors who live here in Jewish Care, who are, due to ill health, unable to attend. Up to the gatehouse, you have to say, up to the gatehouse, it's a huge ladder,
a huge staircase,
and it's really
like
difficult.
It is a ladder.
It is a ladder, really, especially probably when you're 80 plus. And I thought, A, it's always good to do something for a community, B, especially talking about people who came here as refugees, thinking about what's happening in politics at the moment.
So obviously life goes on around you in a care home, and there's a very nice lady with a trolley of tea. Very important.
Tea for us.
I think it might be tea for all the people coming to
True.
See it. So we'll just let her go by.
And it's fantastic to be performing here, first of all, just to do something for your community, for any community, really. I think, especially when you're in the arts, you have the responsibility to not only to perform and entertain, but also to give back to a community. And if you can, with opportunities like this, it's something I immediately said yes to. Second of all, the stories of these people are hugely fascinating, and unfortunately, especially in this country, many people have no idea that in about 10 years' time there will be no Holocaust survivors left at all. I was fortunate enough to speak to many, have some in my family, so it's something that got passed down to me. But many people in about 10 years' time will ask the question, did it ever happen? And there will be no one left to say, yes, it did. There will only be stories. And I think the people who will be here in the audience today will have lived through one of the biggest atrocities in humanity in the last century, and came here as refugees and came here and were welcomed in England. And that's also something very important to remember, that this country used to be very open and is, to a certain extent, still very open. Brexit happened. Europeans should not be scared of living here. They should be here and continue to develop their lives in the United Kingdom, because at the end of the day, they can't just kick us out. Well, we hope, yeah, but they can't.
You say us, so tell us your background.
Well, I was born in Russia in 1990. My parents are both very young, both 20. And the moment the Iron Wall came down, they tried to move wherever, really. Because there was no food, it wasn't very great, communism just broke down, no one knew where the country was going, and they wanted a life, a free life. So we got accepted as refugee Jews in Eastern Germany. It was already United Germany, but it was the eastern part. So I grew up in a first early years in a refugee estate in East Berlin, which was brilliant, actually, because from the get-go, when I was a child, I was sharing a flat, well, my parents were, with a family from Nigeria, family from Ukraine, Belarus, everything, everyone was together. So really, from me, from my perspective, I never had this thing of foreigners or non-foreigners, because I grew up in this atmosphere. Also, Germany post-war was very obviously keen to proclaim openness, and I grew up in Germany till I was 12, and then my parents moved to Israel. I lived there for 6 years, and then I came back to Germany to study biology, did that, and then I came to London to study acting, and that was 6.5 years ago.
What a background. So there should be some, really should have been some songs in Hebrew, or maybe there are.
No, Yiddish, just Yiddish, just Yiddish, yes.
I just wondered. I know you answered one other question. I was going to dare to ask how old you are, but you're presumably about 27.
I'm 27, yes, exactly 27, yes.
Great. And the other question I was going to ask you was, so how do you, you're really going to, hopefully going to connect today with people who may have heard these songs many more years before you were thought of, or even your parents, by the sound of it.
I'm actually quite scared about this, because first of all, especially with the Yiddish songs, some of them, there's a song called Papi Rosin, which is about an orphan, a Jewish orphan in Grodno in Poland, who sells cigarettes, and his sister has died and his parents have died. Incredible to be able to sing about that today, and to hopefully make them remember, hopefully give them good memories, and hopefully make them smile, and hopefully give them a lovely afternoon. Maybe just also have some memories, and it's brilliant to be able here so many years later to connect with these people.
Oh,
the trolley.
Just let the trolley go. It is important, you know, it's the smile and the song and the music, you know, it lifts everybody, I
Yes,
think.
Absolutely. I think music has the opportunity to just make people feel good, and that's what it should be used for. So I really hope for a lovely afternoon. I hope many of them turn up.
Of course they will.
I hope so.
Let's go and find out, shall we?
Yes, absolutely.
Hi, I'm Inga Davis-Rutter. I'm a musical director and a pianist, and I'll be accompanying Daniel at A Song Goes Round the World at Upstairs of the Gatehouse.
And today, here you are at Salie Court doing the accompanying. Actually, I've come in now from outside where I was talking to Daniel, and there are lots of people collecting at tables, which is nice. So it's a bit like a cabaret, isn't it?
It is a cabaret, and I'm really looking forward to it, although I wish my mum was down here.
Oh, where is she?
Grimsby.
Oh, right, she'd love this.
But I don't think I'd get through my Yiddish mama if my mum was down here.
Oh, you're doing that as well, aren't you? So when I came in, you were practising this really, really fast song, Rabbi Elimelech, so a bit of a tongue twister there.
It is, and I'm glad I'm not the singer.
And what's your favourite? I mean, you're doing French, Russian, Yiddish,
German. Yiddish.
Have you got a favourite among the songs you're doing?
The Yiddish numbers, I think are my favourite. I remember my grandpa always talking about my tokus, but yes. that's about the level of my
right.
Yiddish.
Okay.
But I think they've got the biggest pull for me. I think my Yiddish are Mama and Papi Rosen.
Oh, right, I've just been hearing about that. Yes, for those who don't speak Yiddish, your tokus is your behind. I've been very polite to you. So you were brought up in the north then?
Yes, up in Grimsby. It's where all my family are.
Right. Is that a big Jewish community up there?
No, very small. Anyone who was sensible moved to Leeds and Manchester. And when my family got off the boats, they pretty much stayed where they were.
Oh, okay, so. Well, you're flying the flag for Grimsby.
Absolutely.
Well, good for you. Anyway, I'm really looking forward to hearing what you play. So.
Well, we're very much looking forward to performing here today.
Wonderful. He sings with such expression.
Yes. Now, tell me your name.
Bridget.
Sorry, Bridget. Right, so Bridget, you had a wonderful time.
Yes, he's terrific. He's very charming and he's almost acting it.
I think he was acting it, wasn't he? Tell me your background.
Yeah, my background. Well, I came from Germany.
Like Daniel, we can't tell that now from your accent. You sound like you came from the East End.
Well, I came with my parents a little child.
When did you come from Germany?
Well, all right, East Prussia.
Okay, when?
1938.
Right, and you were a baby in arms, I'm sure.
Yes.
Very small at that time.
Yes.
So which songs did you like the best? Did you like the German songs?
Well, I like songs with rhythm.
Yes.
And he had tremendous rhythm.
He did, didn't he? Yes.
And it was wonderful. It made me smile to watch him. He sang songs we call Join In, and it's wonderful.
Jacqueline, you actually are French, is that right?
Oui, oui.
Oh, oui. Oh, we're going to speak in French.
Je suis née à Marseille.
Oh, née à Marseille?
Oui.
Born in Marseille.
J'ai habité Paris. J'ai passé la guerre en France.
Oh, the whole war, and you spent the war in France.
I've lived here since 1914. I got married with an Englishman.
Oh, so you were just telling me in French that you spent the war in France.
Yes.
And then you came to
England.
Sur
la côte, une partie.
On the coast, yes.
When the Germans occupied the whole of France, well, the police helped my parents and gave them false paper because my parents came from Salonika.
From Greece.
Yes, and they gave them false paper, and we went to live next to Toulouse, where a lady was very, very nice lady. Help us and saved us.
So what were your favourite songs today, the French ones? What did you make of his French?
No, anything except the German.
Oh, right, okay, fair enough. But did you like hearing the Edith Piaf song?
Oh, yes, it was very good. Excellent.
Oh, my goodness, we're having a bit of a bit of extra.
Could he come again?
I'm sure he'll come again.
I thought it was wonderful. He has such talent. It's wonderful to see. With what he can do, the languages that he can sing to, it's thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyable. All I can say is, if he can please this audience like he has today, he must be a wonderful, wonderful bloke.
Well, I was sitting there listening to him and thinking he'd be lucky to get a better audience than you. You're all marvellous.
I know, exactly.
He thinks
this
that
is
too.
The best. This is the best I've ever seen the audience. Alan Rubens.
Right, and where were you born in this country?
I was born in Birmingham in England.
Oh,
my
are,
wife was born in Nuremberg in Germany.
Oh, right. Can I just talk to your wife as well?
Sorry, what's your name?
Ellen.
Ellen. Right, so when did you get to this country?
1937.
Ah, right.
From Germany.
And when did you meet your lovely husband then?
Met him in Birmingham, and at the end of this month, we'll have been married 60 years.
Oh, wow. Oh, mazel tov.
Yes,
that's
thank
incredible.
You. Yes.
Did you like it when he sang in German? What was your favourite bit?
Oh, I think the Russians. The Russians, yes. He's very talented. Yes. He's got the wonderful presence and personality, and he'll go far.
So when you came over, how old were you?
I was a bit two.
Rude,
two.
Oh, so you don't remember
no,
so
don't.
Much.
Came with my parents, my sister, my grandparents, yes.
Well, look, I wish you every joy. Mazel tov, I've just been hearing about your anniversary.
Oh, yes. Yeah, we're looking forward to that. Yes.
You got a jolly good early anniversary present today, didn't you?
Certainly. Certainly. It was wonderful.
Yes.
Очі чорні, очі плавні, і манятані страни дальні. Где царит любов, где царит покой, где страдания нет, где вражды запрет.
What's your background?
I came from Vienna.
You came from Vienna? Do you mind talking to me for a second?
For a second, I don't mind talking
Thank you.
To you.
Okay.
You're a charming lady.
What's your name?
Leon Ettinger, from Vienna, born in Vienna.
When
My
did you
parents came from Poland, but I was born in Vienna.
And when did you get to this country?
I came before the war.
How old were you when you came? Do you remember?
14 or 13.
Oh, 14, okay, right.
A long time
You
ago.
Don't look old enough to have been 14 then.
Yeah, you're right.
So these songs speak to you, do they? Do these songs mean something to you, the songs we sang today?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I remember all of them, all the songs.
And what, which language did you like to hear him singing in best?
No, the Yiddish. I can Yiddish and German. Violet und den Stiebes heiß. And the weapon lamp, the kleine Kinder, kommen alle face.
Brilliant. I think you've got a career on the stage ahead of you.
I should have done, but it's a bit too late. Enjoyed it very much.
You were singing along like mad.
I remember the words now in the songs, but I used to sing, but now I haven't got the voice.
Oh, I thought you were singing rather well, actually.
But I enjoy it very much. To see, to hear, it was a big, enjoyable, very enjoyable. And we need that.
Yes, we do. What's your name?
My name is Lulu.
Lulu?
Yes.
Oh, my goodness, you sound like you should be a cabaret artist.
But is it my nickname? My real name is Ren.
Are you from France as well?
No, I was born in Egypt.
Oh, Egypt! How interesting.
And we have been put out.
You were thrown out
because we were British subject. That we have to leave the country.
What year was that?
1955.
Yeah, I understand.
They told us to leave because we were British subject, so they told us out.
What was your favorite song?
One of them.
Audience, we are audience every day. We'll take you with us every day.